How to boost artificial intelligence whilst protecting citizens' rights? That's the question the European Commission is hoping to answer as it unveiled the world's first plans to regulate how the technology is used on Wednesday. The proposed rules aim to curb high-risk uses of AI, like biometric identification, which includes facial recognition, or an outright ban on things like government-conducted social scoring, which China already uses to measure an individual's trustworthiness.
Our proposed legal framework doesn't look at AI technology in itself. Instead, it looks at what AI is used for and how it is used. It takes a proportional and a risk-based approach grounded on one simple logic. The higher the risk that a specific use of AI may cause to our lives, the stricter the rule.
The Commission wants to establish four categories of risk for AI technologies, starting with minimal threat ones, like email spam filters, which covers a large proportion of AI uses. Then there's limited risk AI, like chatbots, where citizens should be aware of what they are interacting with. Next is high risk, which includes credit scoring systems. These will have strict obligations, like human supervision. Finally, will be unacceptable risk. These systems will be banned, like China's trustworthiness rating. But some exceptions for the use of facial recognition might be allowed, but only when deemed absolutely necessary, like responding to terror attacks, or when needed to find victims in cases such as kidnappings.
If we talk, for instance, in the case of facial recognition, there can be some positive uses for that. You know, for instance, you know, unlocking your phone, which is a thing that I do about 100 times a day, and that carries much lower risk than if it was to be used broadly in public spaces for identifying people. So here, what we need to do is really the context, the purpose for the use of AI.
It could take years before the proposals actually become law, but by being first off the blocks, the Commission hopes it can lead the way globally on artificial intelligence.